And now we will learn all about deleting transactions. If you cannot fix a transaction, then your only option is to delete it and re-enter it. Now let me give you an example. If we open the Chase register, we can remember something that we learned in one of the first videos that we saw in this series. We learned that you can change almost any field in any of the transactions in the register window. And once you change that field, QuickBooks will adjust the results in the reports immediately. But one thing that you're not allowed to do is move the money amount from one column to the other. QuickBooks will not allow you to move the money amount of a deposit that was previously recorded into the payment column. QuickBooks will not allow you to move the money amount from the payment column of a payment that was previously recorded into the deposit column. Just watch. If I try to cut out the money amount from this deposit on July 3rd, and I try to paste it into the same transaction but in the payment column instead, after the change warning, you will get a message that says you cannot record a negative deposit. And you're trying to explain to QuickBooks, but this is a check, not a deposit. Too late. You already recorded this with the money in the deposit field, so QuickBooks believes it is a deposit, and it will not let you change it into a check. If it will not let you change it and you want to leave it alone, click Restore, and the highlighted transaction will go back to the way it was. What if I tried the same thing with the July 6th payment? I'm going to cut out the money amount and try to put it in the deposit column. Paste. When I click Record, click Yes for the change, I get the same warning. You cannot record a negative deposit. That's because QuickBooks believes that this transaction on July 6th is a check because you already saved it with the money amount in the check field. Let's click Restore. And that's the situation. You cannot change the column of the money amount after you saved a transaction. Your only choice to fix a mistake like that is to delete the transaction and re-enter it. So for example, let's choose our July 8 check to Verizon, check number 1 from Chase Bank for $200 for the telephone expense. Click exactly on the transaction that you want to delete, and you have two ways to delete it. You could right-click and choose Delete Check, or at the moment the transaction is highlighted, you could move the mouse to the top left and choose Edit, Delete Check. You'll get a warning message asking you if you're sure if you want to delete this transaction. Click OK and notice the transaction is gone and all the transactions below it got pulled up into the empty space. So for example, let's choose our July 8 check to Verizon, check number 1 from Chase Bank for $200 for the telephone expense. Click exactly on the transaction that you want to delete, and you have two ways to delete it. You could right-click and choose Delete Check, or at the moment the transaction is highlighted, you could move the mouse to the top left and choose Edit, Delete Check. You'll get a warning message asking you if you're sure if you want to delete this transaction. Click OK and notice the transaction is gone and all the transactions below it got pulled up into the empty space. Now you may well ask if there's any evidence in QuickBooks regarding transactions that have been deleted. Yes, there is a report that will show you every single transaction that has been deleted since the file has been created. The name of that report is the Voided Deleted Transaction Detail Report. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Voided Deleted Transaction Detail. And of course, as a general rule, always click the pull-down date choice and choose all. Now we see every single transaction that has been deleted since I have created this file. Notice check number one was deleted on June 28th at this time, but check number one was actually added on June 27th at this time. And this was the original information about the transaction, and this was what was deleted. Check number one was also deleted a second time yesterday, or for me, it's yesterday, June 27th. So it will show you every single thing, every single time something was deleted, and what it was, and the date and time that it was deleted. I was practicing this video yesterday, and I deleted the very same check. So if we scroll down a little here, you can see there are more transactions that I deleted as part of making these videos. A little while ago, I made a mistake. It was actually yesterday, because today for me is June 28th. So June 27th, you can see I added a particular deposit, and then just a couple of minutes later, deleted that very same deposit. So you can see this is a very handy report to have, so that you can know everything that was voided and everything that was deleted. Since it's such a handy report, we're going to put it up on the icon bar. Click View, Add Voided Deleted Transactions to the icon bar, and click OK. Very good. Now, you may well ask, what happens in the journal if something is voided or deleted? Well, let's open the journal and take a look. Notice the transaction numbers are here, and they remain consistent up to transaction number 8. Let's scroll down a little. Ah, notice transaction number 9 disappeared. Transaction number 9 was the check that I deleted, 7, 8, 10. Notice it goes July 7th, July 9th. There's a jump in the date, July 6th, July 7th, July 9th, July 10th, July 11th. July 8th was the date of the check that I deleted, and it was transaction number 9. And transaction number 9 will never come back to the journal. Notice this also, transaction 13 is missing. That's because I also deleted the 13th transaction that was put into this file. So if you have both the journal and the voided deleted transaction detail, the combination of these two show everything that has been recorded in the computer, actually into this QuickBooks file, since the moment the file was created. Before we re-enter the deleted check number 1, I'd like to explain a little more about the relationship between the register and other windows in QuickBooks. We already learned that any transaction that we record in the register is recorded as a check in QuickBooks if the money amount is originally saved in the payment column. The reason you cannot change it is because QuickBooks already made it into a check. There's another window in QuickBooks that looks like this. And instead of recording the check in the register, you could have recorded the exact same information into this window. And if you recorded it into a window that looks like this, the result would be exactly the same on the reports and here in the register window. But QuickBooks saves it as a certain transaction type. So once it's a check, it stays a check. The same thing is true for deposits. Any transaction that you record in the register where the money amount is originally saved in the deposit column gets recorded as a deposit, which is this type of transaction. There's another window in QuickBooks that looks like this that you could have opened up and recorded the exact same transaction in the exact same way in this window instead of the register, and the results would be the same in the reports and back in the register. So the register is simply a shortcut to these two windows. But once you save the transaction, QuickBooks records it as this type or that type. And that's the reason you simply can't move the money amount from one column to another. To open up the check window, you can click Banking, Write a Check. And any check you record, you can record in this window instead of the register window. And the same thing is true for deposits. You can click Banking, Make Deposit, and you could record all your deposits in this window instead of the register window, and the results back in the register and the results on the reports would be exactly the same. If you'd like to see how to record transactions in the Write a Checks window or the Make Deposit window, I suggest you watch other videos as part of other courses that I have made. I'd like you to carefully watch exactly what happens in the register when we re-enter check number one. I'm going to put the date of check number one, that's July 8. The check number was check number one. The payee was Verizon, the expense was telephone, and the money amount was $200. Now, before I click record, I'd like to bring your attention to the fact that this register, by default, is automatically sorted in date order. So if you try to record a July 8 transaction, at the moment you record it, it will jump up to what its position should be in date order. We all know that July 8 comes after July 7 and before July 10. And that's where it's going to be at the moment I click record. I click record. Now notice, 7th, 8th, 10th. And the July 8th check is check number one to Verizon. That's because the register is sorted in date order. However, there is additional evidence that something was changed, because you have the ability to come down here and change the sort order to order entered. And as soon as I change it to order entered, notice the July 8th check jumped all the way down to the bottom of the register and is now showing after July 13th. This tells you that the July 8th check was entered into QuickBooks after the July 13th check. And that's another useful tool for finding and fixing date mistakes. Remember, it'll always automatically be in date order. And the other thing you need to understand is order entered makes the running balance column become meaningless. There are other ways that you can sort the register. Largest first, you could sort the register smallest first, but any order except date order, the running balance column becomes meaningless and the only real number is the ending balance. So what you really need to do is keep it in date order until you need to change it.